Hey there, fellow tech enthusiasts. Welcome back to my channel. Today, we are diving into the world of screen recording with an epic showdown between the two powerful tools, ScreenStudio and the FocuSee. But why are we focusing on FocuSee? Well, stick around because we have got some exciting reasons why FocuSee might just be the future for the Windows users. First, let's take a quick look at the ScreenStudio. ScreenStudio is a solid option for screen recording, especially if you are in the iOS ecosystem. It boosts automatic zoom features and a user-friendly interface, making it a popular choice among the content creators. Now let's shift our focus to the FocuSee. FocuSee is actually a game changer, offering seamless screen recording capabilities for both iOS and Windows users. With advanced features and cross-platform compatibility, it's paving the way for a new era of screen recording. Now let's put these two contenders head-to-head, shall we? The first thing is ease of use. While ScreenStudio is straightforward, FocuSee offers a more intuitive experience across different platforms. The second thing is performance. The FocuSee excels in smooth performance even on Windows devices with varying specifications. The number third thing is the customization options. FocuSee takes the lead with its extensive customization features, allowing users to tailor their recording experience. The number four thing is the compatibility. Unlike ScreenStudio, FocuSee caters to both iOS and Windows users, making it a versatile choice for the content creators. Now, let's dive deeper into the FocuSee features.
So guys, here is the FocuSee application. And as you can see, it gives the options to attach the cameras, microphones, and the speakers. And here are the screen sizes. You can go full screen, custom size, and the window. For example, we are going to go to the full screen option, and it's starting to record. Now let's go and capture the screen you want to capture. So for example, I'm going to capture this screen. Now if I click here and go here, now let's keep the recording short and do stop. It would load the app, and basically here you can see the sound.
So here the recording is started. Now let's go
ahead. As you can see, it has the automatic zoom feature added to the video, and even we can control this zoom level if you want. From here you can control that zoom, and if you want to disable the zoom, you can do that as well. Now video enhancements, if you go to the top left side, you will see video enhancements, and from here you can extract the video in any format you want. So if you want a scare format, if you want this format, or if you want a story post format, you can do that. Now this thing is known as the padding, the style. Padding means the gaps between the corners of the screen. And let's keep the original frame so that you can see it clearly. Now you can see if we do increase or decrease, it changes the padding size. Now this is the border color. If you want, you can add the border color. If you want a yellow border, you can do that as well. Now if you go to the roundness means the screen rounded corners, and you can increase them or decrease them as you like. Now this thing is really interesting. It creates a shadow behind the video footage. That's actually so nice. And from here you can change the background you want for your videos. You can use any of these, or if you want, you can upload your own. Here I have some personal wallpapers. For example, let's choose this one. It's applied. And if you go to the cursor, you will see different cursor options. As you can see, the cursor has changed from this one to this. Now if you want to change it, you can change to the different cursor options. Even you can change the mouse click if you want. For example, every time you click the mouse, it will actually change the effect. Now fireworks and different stuff. This is the option for the video cam. If I have opened the cam, it would show how much rounded I want, or options like that. And from here it will auto generate the captions of the videos as well. Now if we different options, and you can select any of these to generate the captions of your video. Now here you can add watermark to the video if you have any watermark or any logo. For example, in this case, let's try to use this one. The watermark is added. You can increase or decrease the size. You can place the marker in any of these positions, and from here you can control the opacity. So that's pretty much it, guys. And once you are done, you can upload it to the cloud if you want. It gives options up to 4K, that is super high quality, and here you can select the frame rates. From here, let's cancel that, and from here you can export the file. So you can choose different formats if you want a GIF or MP4, you want 4K file or a 2K file, and export the files. And that is how it is easy to use the FocuSee software.
Here is how it's easy to use FocuSee for your screen recordings, whether you are on an iOS or a Windows device. But don't just take my word for it. Let's hear what users say about FocuSee. Guys, I have to say, after testing both ScreenStudio and the FocuSee, I am truly impressed by what FocuSee brings to the table. The thought of effortless recording on any screen device gets me pumped up. So there you have it, folks. While both ScreenStudio and FocuSee have their merits, FocuSee emerged as the clear winner, especially for the Windows users like you and me. So guys, give FocuSee a try and let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your fellow content creators. So that's all for today, folks. Thanks for tuning in. Until next time, happy recording.